Had two starters at new positions in that first game. How'd they do?
They did pretty well. You know, there's always room for improvement, but assignment-wise, they did pretty good, played hard. You know, we always, at the O-line position, you're never going to master technique. You just constantly have to hone in, you know, get better every single day, getting back to work, and the little things of the position that make you be successful. You know, it's just hat position here and there can take a play to spring for a big one. We just got to constantly get better every day, every opportunity.
How disappointed were you that the last 10 minutes got scratched to where some of your younger guys could have gotten some time?
You know, I really felt bad for some of those guys. You know, that next series, we had a different lineup going in there, five new guys. And, you know, just like anybody, they put in the work, the effort. And when we went back in there and told them, some of those guys were disappointed for sure.
How many did you play?
Six. I had Hunter Long come in there and rotate. I think he had like 18 snaps or something like that.
Do you mind sharing who might have been in next?
I was going to get, you know, Isaiah Wynn a snap at left tackle. Dashawn was going to go to left guard. Hunter was going to go to center. I was going to keep, I think, Pike at guard, and I was going to put Kendall Baker at tackle. That was going to be the next five.
Good to know. I mean, that's as important as this season is. It's, you know, to think that you're going to have five guys play the whole season without a shoulder or a knee or an ankle and having to come out, that's really a big priority, isn't it, getting that next line.
It is.
Ready to go.
It is. You have to always play the best five, and I'm going to put our offensive line in the best position to get the best five guys out there. And Isaiah Wynn does a good job at tackle. He really does. It's encouraging to see.
Is that right? Mm-hmm. How much work does he get there in practice?
You know, you try to get him some reps here and there and walk through and steal him some reps, but he gets some reps at one-on-one pass pro and things like that. But he does a really good job.
What have you seen so far from Vandy's defensive front?
They're a good group. They play hard, tough, good effort. You know, they've did a good job this first game, and you know we're ready for the challenge. You know, it's about us. You know, it's about us getting better as an offensive line.
Well, how much you're willing to share about this? But obviously, there was the one sack on Bryce, and it was right up the middle. And it's just hard to tell. I went back looking at it. It's hard to tell. Is there was a lineman supposed to pick him up, or it's certainly a back should have been there?
No, it was on us. It was on the offensive line.
Mm-hmm. Is it the center supposed to come down there? Is it was?
No, the center had the other one.
Okay.
So right. It was Pikey.
Okay, I got you. Oh well, yeah. The old vet.
Yep, the rabbit's out the bag. It was on.
How upset were you over that chop block call?
Nah, that was more on me. You know, when guys are slanting and moving, you know, they're playing two gap, you know, you can tell them to man it. And if they're slanting, you can tell them to A it. That was more on me and my teaching, my technique. And, you know, the center should have gone and ripped. But it was a bad, it was a good call. It was a really good call. It was a chop block.
But, you know, couldn't help but notice, you know, obviously you guys had a pretty straight ahead game plan. They did a pretty good job of stuffing you on the first series and the first couple of series really until you had short fields. Is that, you know, obviously everybody's fresh early in the game. I think you guys certainly worn them down. How do you quantify that as to how they were doing versus how you guys were doing?
Well, I mean, we wanted to get our big people on the field and pound on them a little bit. I mean, there are a lot of hats down low, you know, and that's the way it's going to be. And you wear them down, give them body shot after body shot after body shot. And, you know, they start wearing down a little bit, and it's hard to we started getting some loose plays in there. And, you know, it's Chubbs is tough. You know,
yeah.
Nick does a good job. He's a very good player.
How did Brandon look with his center quarterback exchange? You're pretty pleased with that throughout the
He's done a good job. He really has. You know, there's a couple started off rocky, you know, in the first two practices of spring, last two practices after spring game, rather. And he's worked hard on it this summer, and he's done a good job transitioning. He's a good center.
You were like co-offensive coordinator last year?
Last year. Mm-hmm.
Can you imagine the Vandy head coach has now taken on a coordinator title for his defense. I guess responsibilities, the kind of demands that takes for a head coach.
Yeah, it's a lot on your plate. You know, I'd say all the functions that Coach Rick has to do, and you know, just SEC and media and all the time demands, and then also putting in the workload of preparing for third down, goal line, short yardage, all those situational stuff. It is a lot to ask for.
Have you noticed much change with what they're doing with him on the defense now?
There's a few wrinkles, but, you know, a lot of the guts are the same.